Ah, that's my nephew, Scruff, reading that comic book.
Look, Lisa. It's McGriff, the crime dog. Hello, Lisa. Help me bite crime.
Peter Boyle is a tough, ill-mannered cop who is run down in the line of duty. He's reincarnated.
Ha! Surprise!
As a streetwise bulldog in Poochinski.
Remember McGruff the crime dog? Did you ever wish he were just a little bit more handsy with women? Well, the screenwriter of Poochinski did. This is The Pilot is Dead. Hello, welcome to The Pilot is Dead. My name is Matt Dressel, and each episode we're going to take a look at shows that didn't quite make it past that crucial first episode. Today's show is the 1990 comedy classic Poochinski, where I'm assuming the pitch was, hey, you know the movie Turner and Hooch? What if Turner was Hooch? The show starred Peter Boyle of Everybody Loves Raymond, and that guy whose face you recognize but probably couldn't tell me his name if I paid you. Okay, let's look him up. George Newbern. He was in Father of the Bride. And Theodore Rex. This guy was the voice of Theodore Rex, that movie about the T-Rex that solves crimes. This guy read the script to Theodore Rex after doing Poochinski and thought, yeah, that'll work. Actually, what he really thought was,
oh, I like money.
So, let's move on to the pilot. In 1990... Oh, hey, Blue. What's going on? Check the mail? Yeah, we can check the mail. Hey, everyone. It's time for Matt's mailbag. Let's see what people are saying. Chodington Jones 69 says, hey, Matt, do you know what happens when you type The Pilot is Dead into Google? I don't think you thought your title through very well. Oh, come on. It can't be that big. Moving on. DodneyRangerfield@gmail.com says, hey, Matt, you should get a large cardboard cutout of Rodney Dangerfield, like the kid in Where's Rodney? That's actually not a bad idea. Looks like they don't exist. But hey, there's a Rodney Dangerfield mask. Let's look at... Ah! Okay, I think that's enough nightmare fuel for right now. Hey, speaking of nightmare fuel, Poochinski. The year 1990. On the radio, Ice Ice Baby. In theaters, Dick Tracy. And on TV, a little show called Twin Peaks was going to premiere on ABC. So NBC decided to air a pilot for a television show that they'd already not picked up. And... why does that sound so familiar? So NBC decided to air a pilot for a television show that they had already not picked up. Seriously, NBC, what is wrong with you? So let's meet our main character, Detective Stanley Poochinski. Wait a minute. Oh, clever. So Poochinski gets a call on the radio, and this happens.
Hey, who's this?
I'm Casey.
Anyone ever tell you you've got a real sexy voice?
I think this is going to be a real uncomfortable show to watch. So Poochinski and his partner get to the crime scene late and proceed to do no actual police work. But Puccinski's partner has had it up to here with his wacky, rapist-like antics.
You know, Poochinski, I've been covering you for a month, and I'm sick of it.
It's only a month? Seems like an eternity.
And that's basically his character. He hates Poochinski. Please don't change. So Poochinski wanders across three kids pantomiming abusing a dog and kindly asks them to leave. Nah, I'm just kidding. He pulls a gun on them.
Hey, come on. Don't be afraid. You can trust old Poochinski.
I honestly can't even tell if that's a dog or a puppet. So Poochinski makes a new friend at... what? Commercial already? We'll be right back with Poochinski on NBC. We'll show anything.
Just wait here and Daddy will be right back.
Hey, Poochinski, finally found someone to kiss you?
Hey, Schreiber, don't let the word get around.
I wouldn't want anyone to think I've been unfaithful to your wife.
That was actually just sad. Let's add a laugh track and see if that helps.
I wouldn't want anyone to think I've been unfaithful to your wife.
Nope, still sad. So Theodore Rex wants a new partner because, obviously, but the chief isn't having it. Oh, and I love the character actor who plays the chief in this. He's basically made a career out of playing these fiery police chiefs. He was in National Lampoon's Loaded Weapon 1 and Last Action Hero. He also played Spanky in The Wizard with the classic line,
"So you touched her breasts, huh?"
Okay, so out of context, that probably seemed kind of weird. But in context, it's actually a hilarious line about a guy touching a 13-year-old girl's breasts. You know, there's no good way to end this sentence, so let's just move on. But before we do, let's take a minute to remember character actor Frank McRae. In the arms of the angel. Never mind, he's still alive. Let's just roll that back. I feel so alive. It's at this point in the show that we learn that Poochinski is actually a really great cop. When he's not sexually harassing women. Oh, don't worry, we'll come back to that later. And trigger warning, stop watching this video right now.
Who caught the North Hill Strangler? Who caught the post office bomber?
Poochinski.
Don't confuse hygiene with character. There's a lot you can learn from a man like Stanley Poochinski.
No, there's not. Stop acting like we're supposed to like him, show. But maybe I'm judging him wrong. Maybe I'm being like Teddy Rex and I can't see that he's really just an amazing just cut to him doing something stupid.
Hey, you guys want to spike out?
Oh yeah, I'm a little bit short. Can you spare a few bucks?
You're not supposed to order pizza on a stakeout. Comedy gold.
I'm sort of seeing someone now.
Who?
There's this woman, Franny. She's a widow and she lives in my building with a little girl.
So how long have you and the merry widow been going out?
So they argue, the robber gets away and they chase after him. And remember when Poochinski saved that dog? Let's do that again.
Come here. Hey, come here.
And dead. Okay, not really. But the dog comes over and sucks out his soul.
Give me the power, I beg of you.
Seriously, this is not open to interpretation. Poochinski gets hit by the car, he survives, the dog comes over and looks at him, and boom, dead. Oh man. Maybe the kids were trying to kill the dog for a reason. This adds a whole new sinister dimension to this show. I mean, maybe there's more to this show than meets the eye.
Surprise!
Nope. But Teddy doesn't really believe it's Poochinski. Until this.
Everybody loves somebody sometime. Everybody falls in love somehow.
Poochinski, how did you become a dog?
He's at his grave. The dog has his voice. But it isn't until he sings that he believes him.
All I know is I saw this big tunnel and this big shaft of light. And I heard voices at the end of it. Relatives' voices. And they were calling, "Here, boy, here, boy."
That story makes no sense.
You're a dog!
What's wrong with being a dog? You got stronger teeth? You can take a nap anytime you want? You see a girl you like, you don't have to bother with small talk.
Consent is hilarious.
What are you gonna do now?
Well, first I'm gonna try licking myself, and then I'm gonna catch my killer.
Okay, so we finally get to the crux of the show, Poochinski's killer. This is what's going to drive the rest of the series, so let's get right to it.
I'm off the case.
Okay, never mind. So how does Poochinski convince his partner to avenge his death?
What are you doing? You're gonna make yourself sick.
Exactly.
Yeah, I don't really get it either. Okay, now it's time to catch the killer. No more fooling around, no more...
Hey! What's Poochinski's mutt doing here?
It's time for everyone's favorite game, Guess That Punchline! Does Poochinski A, fart on him, B, pee on him, or C, poop on him?
Hey!
I think the dog forgot his line.
Hello, Casey. Would you mind watching this little fella for a few minutes?
Oh no, is there any way we can just skip whatever's going to happen? I mean, at least it can't get any worse. Just cut to it getting worse.
Hi, Robert.
Hi, Franny.
Oh yeah, I completely forgot Amy Yazbek's in this. She plays a widow. She has a kid. And that's it. Okay, so about that killer...
I'm the Huckleberry.
But the killer...
Everybody loves somebody sometimes.
Just only... Hey, dummy, not me!
It's like Beethoven, except stupid. So Poochinski finds a mirror, and that's when things get real.
I've become a dog. It's all sinking in now.
Sure, you're a dog, and that's different, but it's life. It's precious life.
So this is the part where I look into the camera and I pretend that I actually believe that this show has emotion and that it's actually convinced me, and then this happens. Oh, Poochinski, I can always count on you. Okay, so we have 3 minutes left in the show. And it's at this point our main characters literally run into the killer, chase him down, and... And that's Poochinski. It's a pilot that really makes you wonder what the hell was the rest of this show gonna be about? You know, a lot of people consider this to be the worst television pilot ever made. And it's certainly one of the most frustrating. I don't know about you, but when I want a talking dog that solves crime, I want more of this.
Wow! Awesome computer, Uncle McGruff!
You bet!
And less of this. See you next time.
And crack and cocaine to get high, that's what you say you love, but it's really insane. You could die, what are you thinking of? 'Cause nobody's needing that crack and cocaine. There's terrible trouble.